It's like, Rob, we hear that song 17 times a day. Please don't play it at the comedy show. It's a good song. Actually, I want to write a theme song for a sitcom, because that's where the money is. But those people weren't even satisfied with just having a theme song to a popular sitcom. They wanted it to be a hit on the radio, and it's only a 30-second song. So they had to stretch it out to 3 minutes, and when they did, they slapped on more verses and more choruses, and they weren't paying attention. Because, and I can prove it. The second verse of that song has nothing to do with the rest of the song. The second verse goes like this. You're still in bed at 10 and work began at 8. You burned your breakfast so far, things are going great. First of all, I don't know anyone who burns their breakfast because I don't know anyone who cooks their breakfast when they're 2 hours late for work. It's like, I'm late. Where's the skillet? But I would let that slide if it worked for the next line. It's the next line that really bugs me because it goes like this. Your mama told you there'd be days like these. Your mama told you there'd be days like these, but the first line of the song is, so no one told you life was gonna be this good. They forgot what they wrote. 30 seconds into their own damn song. The world is going to hell, we're all clapping along. Well, if you want to enjoy pop music, you can't listen to the lyrics. If you listen to the lyrics of a pop song, it'll ruin that song forever. Case in point, there's this song by Sugar Ray. I listened to the lyrics once and I couldn't like the song anymore because the lyrics go thusly.
Every morning there's a halo hanging from the corner of my girlfriend's four-post bed. I know it's not mine, but I'll see if I can use it for the weekend or a one-night stand.
That guy's a dick. He's about to cheat on his girlfriend. He writes a song about it, and right after that he says, couldn't understand how to work it out. I got some ideas. How about not cheating on your girlfriend? Once again, as predicted, left my broken heart open and you ripped it out. Does anyone buy that? She somehow ripped out Cheater Man's broken heart? And then at the end of the song, it just gets plain scary because the dude actually says, she said we couldn't do it, you know I wanna do it again. And someone in the background says, shut the door, baby, don't say a word. He's a liar, he's a cheater. His girlfriend doesn't wanna do it, understandable at this point. And then his friend comes over and says, shut the... What? They took an episode of Cops and made it a hit song.